So I wanted to give you guys a bird's eye view of what this intake looks like, apart. So basically, we removed the plenum lid of the alien intake here. And as you can see, we've got really nice radiuses going into the port itself. So the airflow, and the nice thing about CNC machining, you can see there's just no mismatch going on there. So the airflow has a really nice smooth transition into each runner. Plus each runner is a nice straight shot into the cylinder head port. So that's one nice thing. It's got a really large plenum volume, which the natural motors and the turbo motors really respond well to. So you got a large plenum volume. And then what I'll do here is I'll kind of show you how the injectors reside in there. So that comes off. If you look at the bottom side of this, it's all O-ringed. So there's really no gaskets. You just tighten it down with some O-rings. Take a look at that. But if you notice, we've built the fuel rail into the bottom of the intake. So for the natural motors, the 8-injector deal, the fuel rail is already drilled and built into the bottom of the intake. So that's kind of a nice thing. You don't have to hang fuel rails, it hides it. The injectors are on the inside, the wiring's on the inside, so that makes a big deal, you know. Along with the MAP sensor and the air temperature sensor and throttle position sensor, it's all built in to the inside of the manifold. So if you look at the runner, see the injector placement on this. This is dual injector. We've actually ported this out for a pretty heavy duty one of our Warrior series, but the injector itself is a straight shot at the back of the valve, and that it really helps fuel consumption. It helps everything in general. Rather than shooting it straight at the floor of the port where normally you would inject it, like this part of the runner, we inject from the other side, you know, and the injectors, both of them, shoot straight at the back of the valve. And that's, you know, it's allowed us to not use as much pulse width. We got more horsepower out of it, and it's really a neat deal that's built into this. Also, these runners are individual, so each runner bolts on to the base itself. I'll show you the base. So you've got four runners that bolt into the billet base of the manifold itself. Uses a conventional water neck style with the thermostat, conventional thermostat, conventional distributor location. So it's really pretty darn trick. Again, now when we say billet, all these are carved from solid chunks of aluminum. This is, you know, just a solid piece of metal that we carve it out. Now this is a shot of the base before the runners are bolted to it. So you can just see, you know, how much machine time is into it. But there's nothing that polishes like billet, and that was one of the reasons why we did it. Now, in the event of the double injector, what we've built is this secondary fuel rail that sits inside of the manifold, like yay, and basically runs fuel to the secondary injectors. And that's nice too, because it just cleans up a lot of the mess. So you can see there's a injectors and the actual fuel rail. One of the real tricks to this whole thing is this fuel regulation plate. Now this bolts to, it sits on the motor here, and then this bolts to the back of the manifold right here. So this is really the brains behind the fuel delivery right here. So what this does is, this is the fuel distribution unit. So basically, you've got your injectors here, which you could, this is normally what we run on primary on the turbo motor, and then secondary. So the fuel comes in, it connects to this, which shoots fuel through this rail into the injectors, but the excess pressure is shot through this passageway right over here into our regulator, which we've designed our own. We've designed our own diaphragms, which fit into the unit here, and this controls your fuel pressure. So basically, the fuel shoots through here. When it gets to a specified pressure that you set, it then shoots through the return hole back to your gas tank. And then it's internally boost referenced by this hole right here, which is O-ringed on the other side, and that mounts to the upper plenum. So for every pound of manifold pressure increase, it's going to increase the fuel pressure. The same thing happens for the secondary fuel. Comes in, goes through right here into your fuel injectors. Then it shoots across into the regulator area and then returns out of this hole. And then, so your entire 16 injector systems, you've got two feeds, two returns, and then and that's it. That's all you've got. You don't have a zillion things to plumb. We've also added eighth pipe ports here where you can pick up fuel pressure. So if you want to monitor fuel pressure for primary and secondary, you can put, you know, electronic gauge or manual gauge and you can read that also. So that's really a nice little deal. Again, the whole back is all O-rings for everything. And that's kind of the brains of the operation for this whole fuel system. It really makes a really trick setup. So together you got the regulator bodies. Obviously this is pretty messy on the dyno here, but your feeds and returns, and you adjust your pressure here. This is only an 8 injector deal, so you were only going to adjust the pressure on one set of rails, but normally you can adjust them both. It just makes for a really clean setup. So this is a 502 cubic inch GM crate motor that you buy from the dealer. What we've done here, we put a hydraulic camshaft, hydraulic roller camshaft, and our billet intake to it, and for it making 610 horsepower, 570 foot-pounds, just put an intake and a camshaft in it. Really just changes the whole demeanor of the motor. Now, no other changes other than a cam and an intake. Still got the GM head, stock pistons, stock everything, other than, you know, a bigger hydraulic roller and our intake. Makes it sound good, makes it sound like a hot rod now. And, you know, again, 108 horsepower increase. And revs of 6,000. And just totally transforms the motor. I mean, drastically makes it bitchin'. Take a look at some of the power numbers here. .538 torque on the start of the pull. 50s, 40, 40, 50, 50, 50, 60, 67 peak. 610 horsepower peak. And this is just a regular GM crate motor that you buy from GM. Put our intake and cam in it. Picks up 110 horsepower. 610 peak horsepower, 500 and almost 70 foot-pounds. But really what makes it so trick is it's just the torque. It varies, you know, from peak torque of 567 to the start of the pull, it's 538. So you only got a 30 foot-pound variance throughout the entire torque curve. It's pretty nuts. Really, really strong. And again, this is just a regular GM crate motor with one of our hydraulic rollers and our NRE billet intake.